Good evening. Thank you for joining us from the comfort of your home tonight. I'm Karen Batchman, Manager of Marketing and Communications for John Knox Village. This year, John Knox Village is celebrating its 50th anniversary. And in a typical year, we would invite you out to the village for an entertaining evening filled with fun and fellowship. However, it's 2020, so why would we do anything typical? John Knox Village's 50 years in existence has proven that we are capable of adapting to the changing world around us. Thank you for trying something new to help us celebrate this milestone. We hope tonight's show will bring you a little joy during this holiday season. Not only will you be able to enjoy an incredible performance by Marilyn Maye, we are also being joined by longtime news anchor and friend of the village, Miss Ann Peterson. You may know Ann from her four decades of reporting and philanthropical work in the Kansas City community. Her relationship with John Knox Village goes back just as far. As a healthcare reporter, John Knox Village was her contact for any senior-related story. We're excited to have such a strong relationship today as we did 40 years ago. Tonight, Ann will sit down with Miss Marilyn Maye to get a more in-depth look at Marilyn's life and her accomplishments, such as appearing on the Johnny Carson Tonight Show a record 76 times, the Ed Sullivan Show, the Steve Allen Show, and the Mike Douglas Show, among so many more. Her long list of distinguished accolades include lifelong achievement awards from the New York Bistro Association, the Jazz Hall of Fame in New York, and New York Cabaret Cares Association. She has also received the Nightlife Critic Award. The list continues. Her list of accomplishments is as long as Santa's naughty list. It's time for us to hear just how she earned those awards. John Knox Village is proud to present the sensational, the extraordinary, the legendary, Miss Marilyn Maye.
Hi. Oh, I'm so glad to be with you. Everybody in the village, John Knox Village, 50 years. I'm told that I was the one that opened it 50 years ago. I was so glad that you found me again, because I want to say, I woke up singing this morning, got out on the right side of bed. I woke up singing this morning and wondering what was ahead. I knew. I took one good look at the sun, and you know, I know I was the luckiest one. It's a most unusual day. I keep throwing my worries away. As an old native-born Californian would say, it's a most unusual day. There is a most unusual sky, not a sound of a cloud passing by. And if I want to sing, throw my heart in the ring, it's a most unusual day. There are people meeting people. There is sunshine everywhere. There are people greeting people and a feeling of spring in the air. It's a most unusual time. I keep feeling my temperature climb. If my heart won't behave in the usual way, there's only one thing to say. It's a most unusual, most unusual day. There are people meeting people. There is sunshine everywhere. There are people greeting people and a feeling of spring in the air. Well, I want to sing and declare. It's a most unusual time. I keep feeling my temperature climb. If my heart won't behave in the usual way, there's only one thing to say. It's a most unusual. So let's toast the unusual. It's a most unusual day. Yes, it is unusual, but we're thrilled to be with you virtually.
This is the way to do it. I hope you're having a good time. I hope you have, you can have a drink. You can have some iced tea or maybe some wine or whatever makes you happy. Just sit back in your lovely living room and enjoy. I'm told that this is John Knox Village 50th anniversary, but I was the first one to open John Knox Village 50 years ago. So it's fitting that I be here to celebrate with all you darling people. We hope we're singing songs that you love. This one is, Hey Old Friend, because you are an old friend. What do you say, old friend? Are you okay, old friend? Are we or are we unique? Time goes by, everything else keeps changing, but you and I, we get continued next week. Some friends fade, oh, they don't make the grade. New ones are quickly made, and in a pinch, sure they'll do. But us old friends, what's to discuss, old friends? Here's to us, who's like us? Then you say with me, damn few. So, I like the East, I like the West, the North and South, they are the best. But I'll only go there as a guest, 'cause I love being here with you. I love the sea, I dig the shore, I love the rocks, and what is more, with you they'd never be a bore, 'cause I love being here with you. Well, I am singing in the shower, laughing by the hour, life is such a crazy game. Hey, I love all kinds of weather, as long as we're together. I love to hear you yell my name,
Marilyn.
I love to hear you yell my name,
Marilyn.
I'd like good wine and fine cuisine, candlelight, hey, I dig that scene. Sha-didn't-do if you know what I mean. Well, I love being here with my wonderful bassist from Kansas City, Mr. Gerald Spates. And our wonderful guitarist. Tonight it's great that we can be meeting you virtually. You know, music makes life better, it's true. Let's celebrate the fact we're here. I celebrate the fact I'm anywhere these days. And I'm really glad I'm with you, because I've planned this party just for you now. I want to tell all you John Knox Village folks, I want to say hello. Tonight we'll feel our friendship grow. Hope our music brings you joy. It's apropos.
that I love. Yes, I love, 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 love. How I love being here with you. Yes, I love how I love. I do love being here with you.
Marilyn, it is so great to see you. Thank you so much for
Thank
all
you.
Of this.
Thank
My goodness.
You, Ann.
What an incredible honor it is for us to have you perform for
us. It's an
for
honor for me to be with you, and certainly with you.
When I say that you are an exceptional artist, that is an understatement. Because when you perform, Marilyn, I mean, you electrify the room, and you
Thank
envelop
you.
The audience with your grace, your elegance, mm-hmm. your passion, and your intensity.
Well, we believe in the lyric, you know. It's all about the lyric, and it's the story that we have to tell. The things that we talk about in the songs are so meaningful. The lyrics are so meaningful. You have to convey those lyrics and know what the story is about and get into the lyric, mm-hmm. not into the aura of singing, you know.
What is your secret to connecting with the audience?
Well, I sing to them, not for them. And I know a lot of people sing with their eyes closed. Mm-hmm. And I don't see how you can make any point with your eyes closed. Because when we talk to each other, this connection. And it's so wonderful to be able to look into the audience's eyes. And people will say, well, in a big theater, how can you do that? And I say, well, it's kind of pretend.
But you also sing with your heart.
I never choose a song that I don't care about, you know, that I don't think the lyric has something meaningful for the audience to grab onto.
We're here in this beautiful theater in downtown Kansas City, the Gem Theater, and it truly is a gem. My birthstone is diamond, and I think it's as bright as any diamond that we can find. So we're proud of it. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. Then I'd want you so much. At long last, I have arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare with the sight of your smile. It makes me weak. And I can hardly speak. And if you feel like I feel, tell me this moment is real. You are just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of that face, that face, that fabulous face. It shines, it glows all over the place. It's got my crazy heart in such a tangle. It drives me simply wild from any angle. I love your sigh, your smile. It just isn't fair. You must forgive the way that I stare, 'cause never will these eyes behold a sight that could replace that face, that face, that face. Whenever I see your smiling face, I have to smile myself, because I love you. Oh yes, I do. When you give me that funny little pout, it turns me inside out. There is something about you, baby, I don't know. Well, isn't it amazing that a woman like me can feel this way? Tell me how much longer. It'll grow stronger every day, every day. 'Cause the only place I wanna be is right here with you, where I can see you smiling at me. I was born to make you happy. I think you're just my style. everywhere I go, I'm telling everyone I know, I'd love to see you smile. Don't want to take a trip to China. Don't want to sail up the Nile. That's the Nile. Don't want to go too far from where you are. I'd love to see you smile. In the winter, in the springtime, in the summer or the fall, the only place I want to be is where I can see you smiling at me. Like a sink without a faucet. You're right. Like a watch without a dial. Hey, what would I do if I didn't have you? I love it when you smile. I love to see you smile. When it's raining, when it's storming, when the wind is blowing strong. Yes, the only place I want to be is where I can see you smile at me. In a world that's full of trouble, you make it all worthwhile. So what would I do if I didn't have you? I love it when you smile. 'Cause never, never will these eyes behold a sight that could replace that face. I like that. I love your faces, guys.
Marilyn, tell us your story. How did you start singing?
I was singing when I was 3, you know, and I was entering amateur contests when I was 8. I had my own radio show, and they offered one of the prizes in an amateur contest. It was in Topeka, Kansas, at a radio station there, that you could have a show of your own for a certain amount of weeks. Mm-hmm. And I won that prize. Mm-hmm. I was 9 years old, and you know, doing a little radio show of my own every week.
Well, and there are so many people, children, who just dream of being an actress or a singer or a dancer. But how did you make that a reality?
I sang a lot in high school, and there was an agent in Des Moines, Iowa, and he booked me on the weekends. We played nightclubs. I was really too young to be in the nightclubs. I was like 15 and 16 by that time. My mother carried a little book, and she would write down what age I was to certain people. And at this person, I was maybe 13 because she wanted them to know my real age. Mm-hmm. And then at somebody else, I had to be 16 or more, so she'd write that down. So crazy.
So how did you get discovered?
I worked here for 8 years here in Kansas City at a club called The Colony, and I'll bet a lot of mm-hmm. the people that are at John Knox Village will remember The Colony.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Because they came to hear us. We were there 5 nights a week, and my daughter was growing up, so we were there all through the winter. We would travel to Lake Tahoe and Vegas in the summer. We were booked because she was out of school. We were very successful with that little club, The Colony on Broadway.
Wow. Wow.
And from that came Steve Allen. And Steve Allen heard me and asked me to do his national television show in California at that time. And I did it probably 5 or 6 times. I would fly out to do the national television show and then fly back and work in the Colony in this little room that could seat maybe 40 people. And from the Steve Allen show came RCA. And I said, well, I've had an offer from Dot Label. I'd already had an offer. And he said, no. He said, I want to do full orchestra. Mm-hmm. I want it to be really, really special. And this was a full orchestra with, you know, violins and the whole yard of what. It was fabulous. So I did Meet Marvelous Marilyn Maye, and then we did the 2nd of May in the living room. It was live at the living room in New York. And then The Lamp Is Low.
So, many people described you as the magical musician, that you are the quintessential queen of cabaret. When you perform, you're combining Broadway, jazz, and all of it together.
Yeah, that's...
And so how would you describe your technique?
back to singing to the people, not for them. And just singing, you know, just learning as I've sung for so long, and I know the difference when it's in tune and when it's out of tune. I've got a real good ear, and I'm blessed. I'm very blessed. Lots of it is God given. I think you can learn so much, but I think a lot of it is given to you naturally.
So as we're talking about smiles, we want to sing this old song. I've never really sung this before, and I decided that this is the time to do it. So smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile through your fear and sorrow. Smile, and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. So light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Though every tear may be ever so near, that's the time. You must keep on trying. Smile. What's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile. When you're smiling, when you're smiling, the whole world, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, keep on laughing. And the sun will be laughing too. But when you're crying, it brings on the rain, so stop your sighing. Come on, be happy again when you are smiling. Keep on smiling. The whole world smiles with you.
Was your inspiration through the years as your career was developing?
Well, a lot of different people for different reasons. Mel Torme and, of course, Ella. Ella for the jazz aspect. Although Ella isn't just jazz, she really delivered the lyrics so incredibly and sang so fabulously. Mel Torme, just the best. And Joe Stafford, who sang perfectly in tune. Her intonation was just right in the middle of that note. And I think I have that talent, too.
You certainly do. Well, you also mentioned just a moment ago about Ella Fitzgerald and that she was very instrumental in your career.
But we were just buddies. We were just friends.
Yeah, but and you had a special relationship with her, didn't you?
We did.
Tell us about that.
We would meet in dressing rooms. Mm-hmm. And because she was busy and I was busy. And the first time that I ever met her was in New York. And actually, I was doing a Lincoln Mercury commercial, and it was to a tune called "Everyone Here, Kindly Step to the Rear," and as Lincoln Mercury leads the way, you know. So they got Ella, and here's the microphone, and Ella's on that side, and I'm on the, you know, the mic was here, and she's over there, and I'm here. I couldn't believe having her like that, and we became friends, you know. And then I would be working in New York, and she would come and hear me at the Rainbow Grill. And after my show, then she would meet me in the dressing room, and we'd sit and talk for hours in the dressing room. Then I would hear her in Houston, and we'd go to her dressing room and talk. It was funny how we always wound up in dressing rooms together, but we could sit there for hours after our shows, you know, and talk talk about the musicians and the music world and our hair and our clothes and just, you know, it was just wonderful to be with her. She was very shy. She was really a shy lady. And but so sweet and so honest and true, and she never knew how great she was.
And everyone loves you, Marilyn. Well, everyone loves you.
Not everybody. I can give you five on one hand.
No, actually, I have to say, and as we all know, one of your biggest fans was Johnny Carson.
Oh, he was.
And the fact that you hit the record books by being on his show 76 times.
We did.
How did that happen?
Well, they just kept calling. And
well,
I kept getting on the plane. They kept sending me a ticket. And he was so good to me. They would say, do you want to sit down and talk? You can sing one song and sit down and talk. Mm-hmm. Or you can sing two songs. And I always voted, I think there were only five times that I sat down and visited with him out of the 76. Because I said, this is what I'm about. Mm-hmm. I'm about the music and about the singing. So,
how was it to sit next to him and talk? What kind of a person was Johnny?
Well, he's
Johnny
darling,
Carson?
And he's very hip. You know, he was very, very, very musically hip. He really knew what you were doing. He was so observant of what you do. Here's his desk. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you've seen people at certain desks, then when something's going on over there, they turn over and talk to these people over here.
Right,
you know?
Right.
And when I was singing, he was totally turned around and paid attention. You know, Ed McMahon brought me to the show. Mm-hmm. He saw me at the living room. There was a wonderful club called The Living Room in New York. And I recorded my second album there, live at The Living Room. And Ed happened to be there one night. And after my show, he said, "You've got to do the Tonight Show." And I said, "Yes, well, yes, I really do." So what song are we doing now? We had a request for this. I recorded this in 1967. It was my fifth album on RCA label. And before I recorded it, I was in New York. We were recording in a place called Webster Hall. And in those days, there wasn't, you know, the singer back in a studio and then everybody separated. Everybody was together. Everybody played and sang, and you got to be good on maybe the first or second take. So I saw this show called Bye Bye Birdie. And Dick Van Dyke was the cutest thing I ever saw. And this song is what he sang. Gray skies are gonna clear up, put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up, put on a happy face. Put on your safety mask, it's vital now. This is the style. You'll look so good, you won't lose sight of how you love to smile. So, pick out a
pleasant outlook. Stick out that noble chin. Wipe off that full of doubt look. Slap on a happy grin. Spread sunshine all over the place. Put on a happy face. When you're feeling mean and grouchy, there's no money in your kick. When your disposition's ouchy and you're feeling kinda sick. When your wife has packed and left you, 'cause you came home kinda late. And your girlfriend telephones you, she's got another date. When your dog just growls and bites you while you are patting him on the head. And your best friend starts an argument, winds it up like this.
Drop dead.
When your car breaks down while you're uptown, go take a bus. Don't fuss, don't cuss. You've got to adjust. Don't you frown. Put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. You are feeling cross and vigorish. Don't start to whine. Think of banana splits and licorice. Oh, you'll feel fine. I know a guy so gloomy. He'd never laugh or sing. He would listen to me, and now he's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place. Put on a happy place. Erase that frown. It's out of place, that frown. Just laugh it up, and you'll feel fine. Tell old man Bloom he's out of line. Put
How do you think your Midwestern roots influenced your career?
I think my friendliness with people. I think that I think we're friendly and we're not phony people, you know. But when we work in New York, it's interesting because people are, in at least in my business, are just like Midwestern. They're friendly, mm-hmm. and they're not shy to come up and say hello to you. As a matter of fact, Midwestern people are not always that forward. They kind of stand off and wait for you to say hello. With us, there's no phony persona.
Precisely.
I think we really kind of believe in what we're singing and what we're saying and what I'm doing. It's very important to me. This is not my hobby. Mm-hmm. This is, first of all, it's my business. Certainly, it's my love. And it's my life.
Well, you know, you also have a big fan base at John Knox Village.
And oh, I'm so glad.
Yes, you do. And there are several residents that shared their stories on how you have touched their lives. Dick Erickson, he says that you are a darling of our city. And he recalls one of your performances, which he attended at the Kansas City Playboy Club the President Hotel in downtown.
Yes.
And he was with some of his neighborhood friends.
Yes.
At the 7 o'clock show. They loved your show so much that they decided they were going to stay for the second show.
Right.
Well, they had a table right in front, and there was also someone else who had that table reserved for the second show.
Oh,
and you know who it was?
Who was it?
It was the Kansas City Chiefs vice president at the time, Jack Stedman.
Oh, and Jack Stedman became my very dear friend.
Yes. And so they worked it all out so everyone could enjoy your performance.
Isn't that fun?
Well, and you were talking about the Colony Steakhouse.
Yes.
And actually, one of the other residents at John Knox Village, Celia McElhaney, she says that she has a very, very special memory of you. It was on her 21st birthday.
Oh, dear.
And she and her friend went down to the Colony, and you were, of course, playing with the Sammy Tucker trio.
Right.
And she says that you sang Happy Birthday, and she was just so taken by that.
Oh, darling.
It was so special. And she wrote you a thank you note, and then you graciously replied to her note.
Oh, I'm so glad I did.
Yes, you did. And not only did you reply, but then you said, I would love for you to meet me backstage at one of my next concerts. So she came to the Quality Playhouse.
Yes.
And Quality Hills Playhouse.
Yes.
And that was very special.
So it's so lovely to be able to play in our hometown.
It is. It's very special.
Yes,
it is. And then the third person is Jay Morris. And he just, and I think he sums it up for all of us when he says that you are beautiful, you are outstanding, and that you have an incredible voice. And he says, just the thought of you gives him goosebumps.
Tell him I love him too, Jay.
This is from another Broadway show. What's the name of this Broadway show?
This is Wildcat.
This was called Wildcat. Lucille Ball was the star of this. And I love what it says. It says, hey, look me over, lend me an ear. Fresh out of clover, mortgaged up to here. But don't pass the plate, folks, don't pass the cup. I figure whenever you're down and out, the only way is up, and I'll be up like a rosebud high on a vine. Don't thumb your nose, but take a tip from mine. I'm a little bit short of the elbow room, but let me get me some, and look out, world, here I come. So, of course, I wrote lyrics for you for this, and I say, hey, look at me now. It's my delight to thank you, 'cause I see how you're watching us tonight. Right now is the party. You know, we're celebrating 50 years of the anniversary of the wonderful John Knox Village. This is the way. I want to sing 'cause I'm grateful, and I simply have to say, forget all the bad news, keep a cheerful thought. This is the glad news. Just think positive thoughts. Remember, life is a special gift. Enjoy it, that's the plan. And your daily task is to always wear your mask. Say hello, world. You know, this is a very unusual time because we're so happy to be doing a show anywhere these days, but especially for John Knox Village. We've done many there, you know. We've done so many shows there, and all through the years. This song is particularly meaningful this time of year, or any time. This time of what we have going on in our lives. This too I recorded. I think it's on our sixth album. Peter Matt's a wonderful arranger. Ooh, he was the orchestra director on the Carol Burnett show for so many years. And he wrote all the arrangements on my album in those days. And I love what this song says. It was meaningful then, but I think it's even more meaningful today. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, forever, everyone. Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb. There are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there is just too little of. What the world needs now, love, sweet love. No, not just for some, forever, everyone. Lord, we don't need another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow. There are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to shine. Listen, Lord, if you want to know, let me tell you so. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that
that there is just too little of. What the world really needs now is love, sweet love now. No, not just for some, no. We need it for everyone, yes, for everyone. We don't need another mountain. We don't need another river. No, no, no. We need love, sweet love, for everyone. Yes. Oh, listen to me, Lord. Can't you hear me when I say what the world needs now?
We all know that showbiz is a tough business.
It's
really
not easy.
Really tough business. It's not
it's
easy.
It's fun, but it's not easy.
What
it's 24 hours.
It is.
You know, it's not an eight hour a day. It's 24.
What have been some of the challenges that you've faced through the years?
Challenges? Oh, I don't know. Every day is a challenge. That's really hard to say. I think of on and off the airplanes, that's really hard. That's not a lot of fun. Just the traveling. The traveling is the hard mm-hmm. part of it. The packing and the unpacking, and that's really hard. And just keeping it all together. And
a lot of people think that their careers are over at retirement age.
Oh.
But Marilyn, you certainly have proven that theory wrong.
We were working here in Kansas City like crazy. There was a club on the plaza that we would go in and work 2 weeks at a time mm-hmm. and pack that place, you know. Mm-hmm. It was called Jardine's, and we traveled a lot. We worked in Iowa, and we worked in Texas. I worked so much in Texas. So we were working. I never stopped working.
No.
So it's just that we had never been to New York because all the clubs had closed. I did the Copacabana. In fact, Frank Sinatra Jr., became a friend of mine because he followed me in to the club and he came for my closing night and he said, you know, he said, I'm really frightened because he said, you know, I said, you sing great. I know how great you sing. He said, well, he said, but you know, I sit behind a piano and my dad stands up in front of the audience. And I said, but you play piano. Your dad doesn't play piano. That's what you have, you know. So he said, well, thank you. He said, that makes me feel better.
I mean, you really have made the golden years so golden for your career.
Well, and I've met so many beautiful people now. Those clubs, those kinds of clubs, the Copacabana and all, there were no more clubs. Then all of a sudden, this Metropolitan Room opened in New York. And Billy, that you saw tonight, mm-hmm. Was playing there, and he said, you know, that's a good room for us. And I went in, and I said, oh, but I haven't worked New York for so long. I said, well, I'll come in and do the concert, and then we'll do one night at the Metropolitan mm-hmm. Room, because I don't think anybody remembers my name. Mm-hmm. Well, mm-hmm. I got out of the taxi to do my show and go into the club, and the people were lined up down around the corner. It was so amazing.
That doesn't surprise me, Marilyn.
But, you know,
that doesn't
being away
me.
For 16 years, I was just thrilled about it.
It's so lovely that you're in that wonderful place, in the village. You have all the luxuries of life there, and fun people to be with, and fun things to do. And I'm so honored that you've asked me to celebrate this 50th anniversary with you. What's the next song?
Johnny Mercer.
I want to do this. My favorite composer is Johnny Mercer. And I know I love Cole Porter, and I do love George Gershwin, and I love Stephen Sondheim. I love all those great composers, all the American Songbook. I got the first Lifetime Achievement Award last year from the American Songbook Society in New York City. And I was honored with that. And of course, it's my genre all of my life. I've done the Great American Songbook. So this is a lot of Johnny Mercer compositions, and he wrote the greatest songs. And I'll bet there's some favorites of yours out there.
Ready? One, two, three, four.
Thank you. the same old hoodoo follows me about. The same old pounding in my heart whenever I think of you. And darling, I think of you day in and day out. Day out, day in. I needn't tell you how my day begins. When I awaken with a tingle. One possibility in view, that possibility of maybe seeing you. Come rain, come shine, I meet you and to me the day is fine. Then I kiss your lips and the pounding becomes the ocean's roar, a thousand drums. Can it really be love? Can there be any doubt? When there it is, there it is, there it is, day in and day out. Because you're just too marvelous. Too marvelous for words. Like glorious, glamorous, and that old standby amorous. It's all so wonderful, I'll never ever find the words that say enough, that tell enough. I mean they just aren't swell enough. You're much too much, and you're just too very, very to ever be in Webster's dictionary. And so I'm offering a love song from the birds to tell you that you're marvelous, too marvelous for words. Well, you're much too much and just too very, very to ever be in Webster's dictionary. And so I'm borrowing a love song from the birds, from the birds. A tiny bird. Thank you. To tell you that you're marvelous, so marvelous that you must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a wonderful child when you were only starting to go to kindergarten. I'll bet you drove the little girls wild and the little boys too. And when it came to winning blue ribbons, I'll bet you showed the other kids how. Well, I can see the judge's eyes as they handed you the prize. I'll bet you made the cutest bow. Wow, you must have been a beautiful baby. 'Cause baby, look at you now. The moment that I saw you grin, I knew how cute you must have been. What a break just seeing you. It must be great just being you. I looked into each baby blue, and I'm so glad that up you grew. Baby, look at me now. Jeepers creepers, where'd you get those peepers? Jeepers creepers, where did you get those eyes? A gosh old get up, how'd they get so lit up? Gosh old get up, how'd they get that size? Oh, woe is me when you turn those heaters on. Golly gee, I gotta turn my cheaters on. Jeepers creepers, where'd you get those peepers? Whoa, whoa, those weepers. Where'd you get those eyes? Where did you get those eyes? When an irresistible smile such as yours meets an old immovable object like me, you can bet as sure as you live, something's gotta give, something's gotta give, something's gotta give. When an irreversible irrepressible force such as you meets an old implacable heart such as me. Don't say no, because I insist. Somehow, somewhere, someone's gonna get kissed. So on guard, who knows what the fates have in store. From their vast, mysterious skies, we'll try hard, ignoring those lips I adore. But how long can anyone try? Fight, 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 fight it with all your might. Chances are some heavenly star-spangled night you'll find out as sure as you live. Something's gotta give, something's gotta give, something's got to give. Who knows what the fates have in store, 'cause it's you that I adore. And something
That's a long medley, isn't it?
It's a good medley.
I just don't know how you do it, Marilyn. I mean, you have more stamina and energy at 90, 92.
I'm 92.
You're 92. And that is just, you have more energy than a lot of people half your age.
But the secret is vitamins and moving. You got to keep moving. You cannot sit down. You cannot sit down. You've got to keep doing it.
I just can't believe it.
If you don't keep doing whatever you want to do in life, keep doing it.
What is the secret to growing young?
I think the attitude. I think enthusiasm. Don't lose your enthusiasm. Don't lose your love for life, because and your friends, and I'm sure you're surrounded with people. Don't stay unto yourself.
You know, you really... You live life to the fullest.
Well,
Marilyn.
We try to, yeah. I love to travel.
Live for today and
live
plan
for
tomorrow.
It's today.
Today is
every day is a party.
Every day is a gift.
Every day is a party.
It is a party. It is a party.
It's Christmas. This is Rod Fleeman playing. Christmas song that I do love. Who wrote this, Billy?
Mel Torme.
That's why I love it so much. One of my favorite singers in the whole world is Mel Torme, and then Ella Fitzgerald. Probably Ella first, I have to say, because she and I were friends. Mel and I were friends, too. We had a very lovely time in those days when we all were working in towns and we would meet each other and talk about how tough the business is, or how much fun it is. So Mel wrote, chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's got lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92.
It's been said many times, many ways. Merry Christmas to you.
Oh, this is a good idea. Let me do this one. What is this? Oh, have yourself. Yes.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles, miles away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days. Gather near to us once more. Through the years, I hope we all will be together. If the fates allow, so let's hang a shining star above the highest bar. Christmas now. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel. Said the night wind to the little lamb, do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb, do you see what I see? There's a star, dancing in the night, with a tail as big as a kite, with a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? A song high above the tree, with a voice as big as a sea, with a voice as big as a sea. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, do you know what I know? In your palace warm, mighty king, do you know what I know? There's a child who shivers in the cold. He will bring us silver and gold. He will bring us silver and gold. Said the king to the about a child who sleeps in the night. He will bring us goodness and light. He will bring us goodness and light. Do you know what I know? There's a voice in the night. He will bring us goodness.
During this holiday season, what message do you want to share with everyone?
We just did, vocally. All the Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas and the Christmas song, Merry Christmas to You.
What is your favorite Christmas song?
I don't have one because there's so many good ones. I can't, there's no way to pull out one particular song. I do love Do You Hear What I Hear, and I was glad that we were able to include that in our program. And I do think it's maybe one of my very favorites, but there's so many that are so good. And, you know, I love Shalom. I love that Jerry Herman wrote. And it's not a Christmas song, but it has a great message. And all the... all the wonderful Christmas songs, it would be hard to pick a favorite.
On the day I was born, said my father, said he, I've an elegant legacy waiting for thee. It's a rhyme for your lips and a song for your heart, just to sing it whenever your world falls apart. Look, look, look to the rainbow. Follow it over the hill and the stream. Look, look, look to the rainbow. Follow the fellow who follows his dream. This song was the truest gift to give to a child. Oh, the lore of that song kept me running wild. You'll never grow old, and you'll never stand still, with whippoorwills singing beyond the next hill. Look, look, look to the rainbow. Follow it over the hill and the stream. Look, look, look to the rainbow. Follow the fellow who follows his dream. So I followed my heart, and I roamed the world free, to the east with the sun, to the west with the sea. I searched all the earth, and I scanned all the skies. Then I found it at last, in my own true love's eyes. Look, look, look to the rainbow. Follow it over the hill and the stream. Look, look, look to the rainbow. Follow the fellow. And somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I've heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops, away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me. me rainbows, make me spring in the snow, make me beautiful music wherever I go. Make me unwind, leave behind rhyme and reason. Make me a room where I'll bloom out of season. Make me sunsets, paint our names in the sky. Let your arms be my wings, and together we'll fly. Don't let me fall till I'm all I can be. Make me rainbows, star-spangled rainbows. Make those rainbows for me. About rainbows and what's on the other side. Rainbows are visions, merely illusions. Rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, yes, and some choose to believe it, oh. But I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Who said each wish would be heard and then granted when you wish on a morning star? Well, somebody thought of that, and someone believed it, and now... Now look what we've done so far. What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? What do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow. The lovers, the dreamers, and me. You and me. Wait and see.
And I actually have to say, I have a special story too.
Yes.
Because I remember 32 years ago, Marilyn, when I was like 6 months pregnant with my first child, and we did a show for the American Red Cross.
The Red Cross. I wrote the show.
And you sang and I danced.
Yes, you did. I wrote the whole thing. They came to me and they said, "We know that you do your own arrangements," which I do. "So we want to do a special show about the Red Cross." And I said, "I would love to do that." It really was inspiring to me. So then I said, "But I want to use celebrities in Kansas City, various Kansas City celebrities." And you were a star. You are a star. Yeah. And you were a star then.
Thank you.
And tell me what you were doing at that very time.
Well, I was a news anchor at KCTV5, CBS station here in Canada.
And I said, "Well, can you sing?" And you said, "Oh, I don't want to sing." And I said, "You can say, but I danced."
I danced. And you came over to my home, and yes, we worked on, we rehearsed the number. And I will have to say, Marilyn, I remember that moment like it was yesterday.
Is that fun?
You know, there are memorable moments in our life that really just stay in your heart forever. And that
is definitely one of them. I'm thrilled that you do remember. It was a lovely time. Well, these are meaningful lyrics, if there ever was a meaningful lyric at this point in time in our lives. So just learn them, learn these lyrics and live by them. Because, you know, the secret of life is enjoying the passage of time. Anyone can do it,
There is nothing to it. Nobody knows how we got to the top of the hill. No, but since we're on our way down, we might as well enjoy the ride. Enjoy the ride. Now the secret of love. Open up your heart. It's okay to feel afraid, but don't let that stand in your way. Everyone knows that love is the only road. And since we're only here for a while, we might as well show some style. Give me a smile, isn't it a lovely ride? We go sliding down, don't try too hard, it's just a lovely ride. It's a lovely ride, yes, life is a wonderful ride. Now the thing about time is the time isn't really real, oh no. You see, it's just your point of view. How does it feel for you? Einstein said he could never understand it all the planets spinning in space, the smile up on your face. Welcome to the human race. Isn't it a lovely ride? Yes, we go sliding down, gliding down. Don't try too hard. It's a lovely ride. It's a lovely ride. Life. It's a wonderful ride. Just keep that in mind. Because I say, no complaints and no regrets. I still believe in chasing dreams and placing bets. And I have learned, for all you get, it's all you give. So you give it all you've got. I've had my share, I drank my fill, and even though I'm satisfied, I'm hungry still to see what's down the other side, beyond the hill, and do it all again. So here's to life and every joy it brings. Yes, here's to life, to dreamers and their dreams. When you're young, the notes are never wrong, and soon you learn that near the music you belong. Wish we could turn the years into a longer song. Oh, I'd sing it all again. So here's to life and every melody. Yes, here's to life and all our memories. It's funny how the time just flies, how love can go from warm hellos to sad goodbyes, and leave us with our memories we've memorized to keep our winters warm. For there's no yes in yesterday, and who knows what tomorrow brings or takes away. As long as I'm still in this game, I want to play for laughs, for life, for love. So here's to life and every joy that it brings. Here's to life, to dreamers and their dreams. May all your storms be weathered and all that's good get better. Here's to life, here's to love, here's to dreams come true. May all your storms be weathered and all that's good get better. Here's to life, here's to love, here's to you, here's to you. Cheers.
What song best describes your life?
It's today. It's today. And here's to life, and the secret of life. Those last three songs that we did on the concert has all the meaning for me and for anybody who's reaching. If you reach the age of 70 or 60, you know, just listen to those lyrics and live by those lyrics.
I love that song, Here's to Life. Yeah. It really does epitomize the essence of living life
and,
to the fullest.
And the secret of life, of course, that's James Taylor. You know, mm-hmm. He wrote that, and I do it very differently than he. And his sister heard me do it and sent him a copy of it, but I haven't heard. Well, he did send us a note, so that was nice. But the it's today that Jerry Herman wrote. You know, it's light the candles, get the ice out. Roll the rug up.
So this is my mantra. I believe in all these lyrics. Jerry Herman, he's not with us anymore. And he lives on through these great, great melodies, great lyrics. So in a show called Mame, I had the good fortune of playing Mame. And it was a joy because Mame believes in what I believe in. She says, light the candles, get the ice out, roll the rug up. That's the rug. It's today. Though it may not be anyone's birthday, and though it's far from the birth of the year, I know that this very minute has history in it. We're here. It's the time for making merry, and so I'm for making hay. Tune the grand up, dance your shoes off, strike the band up. It's today. I know every day is a winner. To me, every day is a gift. I'm sure that the very momentum of life has to move, so you'll prove that it's nifty. To me, every night it's a party, and each new night it's a ball. So get out there, grab a heart and start to live, love, and laugh at it all. There is a thank you can give life if you live life all the way. So raise the roof up, pour the scotch out, pull the stops out. It's today. Yeah, we're still living, and we're well gang, still raising hell gang in our special way. So tune the grand up, dance your shoes off, strike the band up, brush the blues off. Hallelujah! It's today! Yes! We love you. I hope you loved us. Please remember, light the candles, get the ice out, roll the rug up, it's today. I love you all at John Knox Village. Thank you for inviting me to your wonderful party. It's a party. This is Marilyn Maye. My wonderful musicians, Todd, Rod, Gerald, Billy, I love you all. And I love you especially. Good night.